If you just try it once, just get in a busy elevator. Everyone at home, please try this.
I tend to be
just get in a busy elevator and say out loud before we get started, would anyone like to get out and just see what happens?
Hi, I'm Anthony Russo.
And I'm Joe Russo, and you're watching our absolute scenes for NA.
But
in all
seriousness, you gotta tell me something, okay? Do I smell like beer?
Yeah.
But you know what I don't smell like then? Cigarettes and weed. That one's free.
The dream continues, still undefeated.
Yes, nice.
Look at this guy.
We prioritize the work experience as much as we prioritize the work. So
it's funny that you bring that up on that movie because I also remember we shot on a beach in Hawaii. It was, I think, the only time we've ever directed barefoot.
Yeah.
Which was nice.
No, it was an actual bar, right?
It was an actual bar. You know, wasn't it like that, wasn't it in Venice? Or no, am I confusing it
Hananu?
With another
No, I think
bar.
I thought it was in the Valley, that bar. Right? It was like a sports bar in the Valley.
Possibly.
Yeah. Seth is very fond of that movie. He'll tell you so. Oh, yeah. Yeah, he talks about it all the time. He was working on 40-Year-Old Virgin at the same time. So Apatow was over. Like, the studio told us because of the cost of the movie that we could not make it an R-rated movie, so we're stuck making a PG-13 movie. And he was over making this, like, really, really hard R movie in 40-Year-Old Virgin. And I remember we had to go see an early cut of that. Judd asked us to come see an early cut. And we walked out of the theater and we're like, yep, that's how you make a comedy. Well, there was a script actually by Rogan that the studio wouldn't let us shoot that was completely nuts. I mean, it was just imagine a Seth Rogen script. Like, it was totally insane.
Yeah, it was just the more adult version of the same basics, at least.
That was one of those problem. I mean, Anthony, I always say on that movie, we learned a hard lesson on that film, is that, you know, we were probably sixth person on the totem pole on that movie. Like, the composer had more power than we did. So we decided not to go back to films until
that was early on. Yeah,
yeah, we had reached a point where we felt like we had control. So, you know, fortunately, Marvel was a place that you know, once you got your vision past them, they were pretty wide open. I mean, we, you know, Anth and I like excess. It entertains us, you know. We love The Raid. I thought it was one of the best action films ever made. We love John Woo movies. You know, this was certainly, like, more in the vein of, you know, excessive action. Certainly 80s American action films. I mean, take your pick, you know. But the intention for Extraction was to just make a balls-out action movie. When I originally scripted it, you know, it was something that, you know, Anth and I were thinking about. We're trying to move into the action space. We're getting really tired of comedy. We've been doing it for a long time. And I remember just shooting the shit with Hemsworth on set in between takes on Infinity War. And he was thinking about what to do next. And I said, well, you should check out the script. You know, he wanted to do some action, too. I said, you should check out the script. It's pretty interesting. And Hargrave's really talented. We had Sam attached at that time. And he knew Sam from... obviously from working with him on the movies, on the Marvel movies. So that's how that one came together, if I remember correctly.
Yeah. I mean, there's a specific type of action that Thor does in the action movies.
Yeah, it's he was tired of swinging an axe, yeah. You know, it was or a hammer.
Yeah.
You know, I think he wanted
flying.
He wanted to swing something else.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think he wanted a crossbow at one point, maybe, right? Were there catapults? Do you remember what it was? Yeah.
Until the money's gone, and when the dope's gone, you get sick. At which point, you need to find more money.
Go rob another fucking bank!
I I mean, we just gave him a lot of drugs. Really. That's what we did.
I mean, Tom's very massive. He's an amazing actor. He just like, you know, Tom's worked very hard on that role because it was serious subject matter. He took it very seriously. A lot of research. Talked to a lot of people who had been through those specific problems, veterans. You know, as did we. And it was based on a novel that was more or less a first-person account of those experiences.
From a very fairly famous drug addict, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we were in touch about it all. Like, we did a lot of research in Cleveland, where we're from. The story is very, you know, specific to that place in many ways. So we were there together. We weren't necessarily with him. So we both had our own sort of contacts, and sometimes we would kind of cross meet, but there was a lot of individual time as well. Because, you know, especially when you're talking about difficult life experiences, sometimes it's easier to do it in more of a private situation. Since Marvel, like, we formed a company after Marvel with Chris Marcus and Steve McFeely, who are the screenwriters who wrote all of our Marvel movies, and we have a company together now, and it's an independent company. So basically, every project that we take out, we can take anywhere.
Yeah, and our motto at this point is, gotta get that Apple money.
Yeah.
That's our motto.
Hey, open it.
Not the trunk.
Get in.
I could really use a comfortable chair right now.
We added a second shot in the ass. That was like an improv.
Yeah, we did. I don't remember.
No, it was something we came up with like 2 days before we shot it.
It's hard to do.
Yeah, I think it was Anna. Anna said, "I would prefer to shoot Gosling in the ass." Don't you remember that?
She shot him in the thigh, though.
Yeah. it's a bad aim. We tried that like 11 times. Yeah, she just could not get it around to his ass. She just kept getting him in the thigh. But either way.
It still worked.
It still plays. Yeah.
That was an easier ass to hit for some reason.
I mean, it's America's ass. Yeah. It just has this sort of scale to it. It's hard to miss. Yeah.
I think, you know, Joe and I are very actor-orientated. We love performers. Big part of our process is, you know, when we invite them into the process, just sitting down with them, reading the script with them, talking about the character with them, really trying to find where they connect with the character most, and also seeing what their ideas are, what they can bring to who this person is. And then we sort of use that, and we'll go back and rewrite the script, and it'll be a nice flow between us and the actors as we execute. So certainly, it was very important for us to, even though the movie is kind of structured as this mano a mano between the Chris Evans and Ryan Gosling character, we wanted to have a really strong female lead, so it was important to us to really work with Anna and sort of find all the opportunities we had in the movie for her.
I remember she asked for a period at the end of that one line. It was a comma. Or no, it's an ellipsis. And she wanted just a little bit more of a statement made.
Do you remember that? Yeah.
Yeah.
It required
some discussion, but, you know, eventually we gave in. I like ellipses, but apparently I overuse ellipses. You know, and it just, you know, bothers people. He went mustache first with that character.
He grew it for the role.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it was really curated.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah, and then Gosling, I think, you know, that came out of some research of Gosling, we had been doing, and Gosling had been doing with some CIA, former CIA agents, former special forces operatives, and just sort of ideas about anonymity and sort of how you cloak yourself. And it seemed that's a technique that's useful.
And it's important to, like, cloak your lip. The lips, they're very recognizable.
Before we get started, does anyone want to get out?
Thank you.
I mean, it
we
might.
We did it twice and we revisited it.
Did we do it twice?
Well, we revisited it in Endgame.
And then Endgame?
Yeah.
And then so. The community did it thrice.
Yeah.
It was thrice. Yeah, I forgot we did that again. That's what happens when you get to my age. Yeah, that scene was the first thing we shot in the Marvel Universe. Yeah. So I think it, just for that reason, it has some emotional staying power with us, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. And also, you know, we were very intent on sort of redefining who the Captain America character was in that film, because we felt like we had license to, because he had been away for 70 years. He was coming back to a world that he didn't know, without any, you know, all the people he was close to are gone, etc. We felt like we had an excuse to sort of for the character to have a new point of view.
He was angry.
Yeah.
He just wanted to beat some people up, so we let him beat some people up. Have you never said that in an elevator before we get started?
No.
If you just try it once. Just get in a busy elevator. Everyone at home, please try this.
I tend to be very
get in a busy elevator and say out loud, before we get started, would anyone like to get out and just see what happens?
I like to be very polite in elevators, generally.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
And it's good experience when people react that way, and you know, they sort of have this collective insanity.
I mean, look, you know, part of the thrill of those that movie was it was the culmination of such a long journey through so many films. So you're talking about a moment like that where, you know, and everybody's memory, of course, goes back to when everybody was trying to pick up Thor's hammer in the original Avengers, you know, so it's that long arc that people have with those storylines and those characters that ends up paying off, and yeah, it's quite a moment.
Yes.
Yeah, I guess so. I mean, look, the thing with Joe and I, we love those movies, we love the comics, so it's like the opportunity to make those movies is so amazing to us. The opportunity to make any movie is amazing for any filmmaker. So really, like, what we get focused on is just, like, the rarity of the opportunity, the fact that we get to come together with so many collaborators, the fact that we have a financier or studio behind us giving us money to make this crazy idea that we have, you know, it's all, you know, that's really where the pressure comes from, is just like, wow, this is a moment in time that we can actually do this and we should get it right.
Do you remember that almost became Thor's crossbow moment? Do you remember that?
No, it's catapult.
Oh, it was the catapult.
Yeah.
We had a talk comes without it.
Yeah.
It didn't have the same effect, lifting a catapult. It really didn't.